Here we focus on addition with mixed fractions, and we'll see that here, as well as the general concept of addition of fractions where we need common denominators, we also need to take into account conversion between improper fractions and mixed numbers. So we'll do the first one in a fair bit of detail, and then we'll do the second ones just using our techniques that we've learned. So let's have a look. Now, one of the first things to draw your attention to with a mixed number, so with something like 3.5, this implicitly means 3 + 1/2. So even though we don't write the addition symbol in there, you do need to keep in mind that it is referring to addition anyway. So sometimes when we're doing the addition process, we separate things out. So our first step usually with adding mixed numbers is we'll add the whole number parts together. So here we have this whole number and this whole number. And so we're going to be adding the 3 and the 1 to get 4. And then we're adding +1/2 + 2/3. And so we're going to leave the 4 as it is and then essentially just focus on the 1/2 + 2/3. Now we'll see with subtraction. With subtraction, sometimes it's better to convert to an improper fraction first. That's not really the case with addition because it would make this next step a little bit harder. So here we've got 1/2 + 2/3. Remember, in order to be able to add these together, we need a common denominator. So we have the lowest common multiple of 2 and 3 is 6. And so we're going to convert both of these to 6s. In the case of thirds, we multiply top and bottom by 2 in order to get our equivalent fraction. And in the case of halves, we multiply the top and bottom by 3. So we've still got our 4 that's sitting out here. And then our equivalent fraction for 1/2 is 3/6. And our equivalent fraction for 2/3 is 4/6. Now, when we add these together, we get 4 + 7/6, but we don't write it obviously as 4 and 7/6 because with a mixed number we need the fractional part not to be an improper fraction. So we need the top number to be, or the numerator to be, smaller than the denominator, the bottom number. So in our next step, what we do is then convert this improper fraction into a mixed number. And so it's 7 / 6, which gives us 1 and an extra 6th left over. So 7/6 is the same as 1 1/6. So we have 4 + 1 1/6. All up, we get 5 1/6 as our final answer. Now, some visual understanding of what's going on here. You know, we have in the top, so let's focus on, let me just get this out of the way. Okay, so with the top part, so we've got 3 ½, so that bit doesn't count, and then we've got 1 + 2/3, that bit doesn't count. So clearly here, when we're adding them together, it's fine. You know, what we can visually see when we're moving all this around is we have our whole, so putting that together gives our 4 wholes, and then we have this mixed part here. So in terms of converting to an improper fraction where we express them all in halves, there's no need for us to express this first one as 7 halves and then add all the halves and thirds together like this. Because then we'd be, you know, it would be too much addition at the end. So we just focus on adding the whole parts first and then dealing with this part of the fraction here, so with this part. And then when we're adding these together, we need to convert them into 6. So implicitly, what we're actually doing there, we're saying, okay, this is my 1/2. So I've got 1/2 there. I'm just going to say that colouring in means that it's not there, it doesn't exist. And then I have 2/3 here. And it doesn't exist. And so by converting them into 6ths, what I'm actually doing is chopping these up, essentially. So in terms of the whole and how many 6ths that is, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So One half is the same as 3/6 on this side. Chopping each of these in half, we can see again visually that 2/3 is the same as 4/6. So we're cutting them into, you know, pieces so that we can add them all together, and we can see again visually that we have 4 + 3 = 7/6 all up here, which was what we got there. We can also think of things like the fraction strips that we used in the class to justify how this works, but essentially that part is just addition of fractions. So again, with adding mixed numbers together, the usual process is to add the whole number part together first. So add the whole numbers, add the 3 plus the 1, and then deal with the fractional part separately. And then as a last step, we usually have to simplify that fractional part into a mixed number. In some cases, we won't have to. In some cases, if the two fractions add together to a number less than 1, then we can stop pretty much before going to that final step. So let's just put that in practice for these next two. So we've got 5 1/8 plus 6 8/9. So we add the 5 and the 6 together equals 11. And then we've got plus 1/8 plus 8/9. We need to add 8 and 9 together. So we look for the lowest common multiple of 8 and 9, or any common multiple works, but the lowest one is usually the best. Or I know in this case, 8 × 9 is the lowest common multiple. So here we're going to be finding common equivalent fractions, multiplying the 8 by 9 and the 9 by 8 so that we get 72. So we have 11 plus 9 on 72 plus 64 on 72, which gives us 11 and 73 on 72 plus, which simplifies into 1 and a 72th, so we get 12 and 1 on 72 is our final answer. So it's just add the whole numbers together, add the fractions together by converting them into a common denominator, and then simplifying at the end. And then finally here, we've got 2 4/5 plus 3 1/8. So the 2 plus 3 gives us 5. So we're adding plus 4/5 plus 1/8. The lowest common multiple for 5 and 8, again, is just 5 × 8, which equals 40. And so here we're going to have 5 plus, multiplying these by 8s and these by 5ths. So the equivalent fractions are 32 on 40 plus 1/8 plus 5 on 40. And so in this case, we just get 5 37/40. So you notice here we don't have to do any simplification at the end. We don't touch improper fractions at all. We just, because our two fractions added together don't give us a number greater than 1. Okay, now see that this does differ to what we do with subtraction. And so I'll do a video on subtraction as well as on addition and multiplication as well.